Grudges among musicians is not healthy for music industry. This is coming from PMAN President Dr. Obi Okudeli Kasmia, who is popularly known as Vumbalistic Uncle P. He spoke with the News Agency of Nigeria, NAN, in Lagos. He said, and I quote, "Grudges amongst musicians is not healthy for our industry and will only create further resentment in their relationships as musicians and may affect what we present or represent to the public. Being emotionally immature when composing or writing your songs means you cannot control your emotions or reactions towards your colleagues." Okay, Ife?
I dare to differ, because if we're talking about the hip-hop culture and we're talking about... I'm not talking about music generally, I'm focusing on hip-hop right now. If we're talking about that, obviously you have competitors, you have competition, you have to show that I'm better than this person, you have to...
Was the hip-hop culture always be that way? Is that really a culture?
I think that's a question we're going to be asking in our reports, which we'll be doing shortly. I think, did I just let the cat out of the bag? But I think that's a question we would need to find out. If it's actually necessary for our hip-hop artists to go against each other. But I understand where it's coming from, but at the same time, I dare to differ. I say sometimes this beef is actually good for the artist in the sense that
people
get to talk about them, they get to sell more records, they get more attention, they get more, as long as it doesn't become violent, like the case of Tupac and Biggie.
And I think that's where he's coming from. Let's take
Niger, we need get that mind.
You never can, you say they are dad fans that can actually like out themselves because they are so-called celebrities.
Yeah, like Naramali and Rugged Man in London.
Well, that's like rumored. But yeah, something like that. You get like, I mean, they are diehard fans that are ready to go any length to support their celebrity and all of that. I understand where it's coming from, but like if I said, it's not something we can take out of the music industry. You will always be there, right? Because people always beef each other. But like, it's just, I feel like they should just keep it really low. That's what I was saying, Emma and Vector, they can continue their rap, dissing and all of that, but they should just let us know that it's not that deep. Because if it's that deep, that's when people will take it that deep. But if it's just about entertaining people, like, okay, I'm just better when it comes to rap and it's not so personal, but their own is already so personal, because he used them as an example, kind of, that you're already getting so personal. Do you get, like...
Especially Vector. I think Vector is very emotional.
I saw someone, I don't know, is that the Rick Ubana handle, saying they were going to drop money for them to have a face-off.
Is what's his name again? Willie XO, $20 million naira. Then he said if you want to hard, you can text him and they will have a face-off at a hotel. But there will be tickets. Nigga wants to make money too.
Brother wants to make money.
Going away from MI and Vector, I feel like you cannot tell people not to put their emotions into their creativity. It doesn't...
No, but if you listen to...
It doesn't really work that way. Most of the times, you write from where your emotions, where it is drifting to. So you're heartbroken, you're writing a heartbroken song. You're sad, you're writing a sad song. You're happy, you're writing a happy song. Or you see them talking about Sammy getting money past you, you're a hater. At the end of the day, whatever you're going through will reflect in your creativity. So I don't think there's a way to separate them, but like you said, it just have to be healthy enough for them to know it is not so personal to get violent.
Now, where emotions can come in, face me when you're trying to diss me. Now, Vector went off, which is what happened in the case of Pusha T and Drake, when we all didn't even know that Drake had a child with a prostitute,
yeah,
right?
We didn't even get to talk about Vector's reply on Friday because we had a guest.
So we all didn't know about Drake's child with a prostitute, but Pusha T came out and he unveiled that. Now that was kind of like unnecessary, which was what made Kanye West squash the beef, like, no, you stepped out of line. That was personal information. It's not something you should reveal. Now we're talking about Jesse Jags. You're dissing MI. What's Jesse Jags on? Jesse Jags is doing his thing. We haven't even heard from...
I'm not trying to be Vector spokesman now, but I feel like when MI brought out his own year, he said a lot of things that, I mean, would have
directly at Vector,
would have touched Vector personally. So I don't think that you don't... I feel like you don't tell people how to express their grief. You can't tell them
it's
that
a grief.
Listen, Yeah, if you see that way.
Vector, you put it to grief.
Oh, ah. If that's how you want to put it. Like when Vector came to reply, nobody was telling Vector that these are the do's and don'ts of the rap, whatever, or this is what you should say.
He claims to be the best rapper in Nigeria.
I mean, I feel like he just came to address issues that Vector quote that, okay, in quote and unquote, these are the people you've helped.
That's even against the bro code.
So I think...
even against the bro code. Because you know...
I really don't think that there's, in this case, in this Vector and MI,
I'm not talking about Vector and Emma. I'm talking about Vector and Jesse Jags. The fact that Jesse Jags is your friend, you know about my struggle, and then you're trying to diss LC. And because I'm LC's co-anchor, you now start coming against
If I gave you the permission? Am I the one dissing you now? Or
okay, so
LC.
Now
what
that
if
we are
I gave
talking
LC
about,
the
so Elsie will give you the permission to this.
Now that I'm talking about,
yeah,
talking
because what if MI has not done him well? I mean,
okay, you two have said your own now. Since we are talking about the reply, for me, I feel I listened to the reply once, twice. I also listened to it twice because it was so good. I wanted to know if my feelings would change. And for me, I think Vector is just small.
Your feelings can't change because you're MI's fan.
No, because...
I know you said no, but I know that you guys are just a diehard.
Okay, so no, I'm not a diehard MI fan.
He's just really small.
Do you know what? I think when he was listening to MI saw the future. He took a pen and paper and was jotting down. MI said, too tall.
Then reply.
MI said, I live with my ex-girlfriend.
Okay, we need to move on.
I don't think there's any problem with him.
And then when he was now writing his own rap, he now put that note side by side. All right. And was now replying. Okay, I have a girl. Okay.
And so what's wrong with
I really
that?
Don't live with my girlfriend.
But if I was wrong with that,
what
I mean, addressing every issue MI spoke about that you people in court took upon yourself that MI has killed Vector. And
no,
it's coming out
MI,
to address all the
that
Vector
has
started
it.
I know,
that.
I don't have a problem with that, with Vector starting.
Okay,
I'm just saying that with you guys.
I think Ewa is very emotional about
it. I'm being emotional. What? I'm just saying how I feel about it.
Does she have a crush on him too?
I don't know, maybe.
Oh,
but you know what?
Can you people not just see this as this is what you think about it and this is why I think about it?
Yeah, but you are getting more emotional than we two are. Actually, you are the one being emotional.
I'm being emotional.
Okay.
I'm just
Vector,
saying
you have
what
a fan, sorry.
But really, that's
well, if that's what you want to say, Vector, you have a fan.